for the sign of Taurus. Hello, and welcome to my channel. Just remember that the bottom cards are paired with the top cards. I'll be going through your past, present, challenge, and outcome. So in your recent past, we have the Three of Pentacles. Now, the Three of Pentacles is a very positive card, particularly with regard to work and career. But it is a very good overall card that you are basically doing very well. And that would have been in the past. Now, with the Three of Pentacles, it tells you that the people around you, they appreciated you, they appreciated your efforts, and they also noticed the quality of what you did, even if you did not get a paycheck. So, with the Three of Pentacles in a reading, it tells you to keep doing what you're doing, as you knew that you were on the right track at that time. Although there is always room for improvement, you knew that. So, you didn't need to scrap something and restart it over. And we have this card paired with the Ace of Pentacles. Now, the Ace of Pentacles, you're likely, or you were likely in the past, to find yourself enjoying new beginnings on many levels. And this was a very positive, or it could have been a very positive new beginning. Or new beginnings, more than one. You were likely to be feeling optimistic, upbeat, and hopeful about your future. Things should have been going very well for you overall. You could have well have started something new right away. This could have been in the area of work, or it could have been personally. But either way, it was a good time for you. And then we move on to the present. That was your past. So in the present, we have the Seven of Swords. Now, the Seven of Swords, it can point to someone you know or someone that you meet. They could be behaving with less than ethical intentions. Now, just keep in mind, that could be yourself, okay? So it's sometimes also means prying into someone's life where you don't belong. Now, if you sense that someone is spying on you, you could be right. If you are tempted to dig through someone else's life, unless it's your children or someone who's giving you cause for concern, you need to resist that impulse, because everyone deserves privacy. And this card is paired with the Five of Wands. Now, if you could see the picture of this card, it clearly shows that it's referring to competition. Now, the competition is usually career or work related, but it does not necessarily mean work or career. It could mean a romantic rival or romantic rivals. Now, don't be afraid of competing. You have to know that you have something to offer and you can be very successful. But try, or you have to try, to see results. Now, when this card appears in a reading, your need to believe in yourself is stronger than ever now. So hold your head up high and have faith that you will end up in the place that is right for you. You may be thinking of a career change, so just know that you can be successful at this time. So with these two cards paired together, the Seven of Swords is letting you know to be careful of your intentions, or be aware of other people or persons' intentions. Be aware of their intentions towards you or your intentions towards them. Try to stay away from prying into others' life. Okay? Because you wouldn't want someone doing that to you. You need to resist that impulse if this is you or if this is someone doing that to you. Because it's paired with the Five of Wands, it could be in the area of competition. Now, if you're in a relationship, there could be competition there, or it could be competition in the work area, and someone's trying to see what you're doing, or you could be trying to see what they're doing at work. So the Five of Wands is letting you know you can be successful on your own. So there will be competition, but just do it in a respectful way, or just deal with the competition in a respectful way. Because the Five of Wands is referring, like I said, to competition, and don't be afraid to compete. But like I said, because it's paired with the Seven of Swords, you have to make sure it's done, or the competition is being held in a manner that's respectable and not disrespectable by prying into someone's life, or if someone's doing that to you, that could be the case also. Okay, so that's going to be the present. Now we move on to the challenge and the Ace of Cups. Now the Ace of Cups is a very powerful card in the tarot. It's relating to love, happiness, and affection. Like all of the aces, it's about new beginnings. And although it usually means love, it can indicate new beginnings in other areas of your life. So things are looking up. In general, or basically, people will be responding to you with happiness, love, and goodwill more than usually at this time. So you should be feeling good about life in general. This is a great time, great time to make new friends. And we have this card paired with the Ten of Wands. Now the Ten of Wands is showing in the picture that you could be feeling as though you're carrying a very heavy burden. You may want to look hard at this and see if there are any ways that you might lighten your load, either literally or figuratively. If you look carefully, you may find that part of the burden you're carrying emotionally actually belongs to someone else. So it's going to be important for you to pace yourself now. Don't try to take on too much. Okay, so with these two cards paired together, the Ace of Cups, it's about happiness, love, and affection, new beginnings, new positive, new beginnings in your life or in other areas. And it's paired with the Ten of Wands. Pace yourself. With these new beginnings and all the great things that are coming your way with the Ace of Cups, pace yourself. Okay, enjoy it. And don't try to take on too much at this time. because it's actually a really good time for you. The Ace of Cups is a very powerful card. And that's going to be your challenge. Then we move on to the outcome. Now the Hermit card. The Hermit card is an extremely spiritual card. Now it often has to do with institutions and large organizations. It could be anything from a bank to the church. Just like with the Strength card, you could even more so be in the frame of mind that you need some time alone. So don't be afraid to take it. Now, even if it's just 5 minutes or a 5 minute walk around the house so you can clear your head, do it. Take it. Take the time for yourself. Now, this is also very much a card about trying very hard to do the right thing, because it's a spiritual card. Okay, just keep that in mind. So just make sure that doing the right thing, and make sure that doing the right thing, it includes doing what is right for you personally, and not just worrying about the wants and needs of others. And we have this card paired with the Ten of Cups. Now, the Ten of Cups is very uplifting. It's one of the most uplifting cards you can receive in a reading. Now, this card, it points to happiness, perhaps in a more mature, grown-up kind of way, as opposed to a less wish fulfillment type of way. But either way it goes, it's a good card. Now, basically, the Ten of Cups, it speaks of happy family life, even if you're single, and to the general well-being that goes way beyond yourself to include those that you are most concerned about, such as your parents, siblings, children, and so forth. So being spiritually fulfilled is also a part of the picture. Now, this is a good card to see, like I said before. It's one of the best. So regardless of the situation or your question or concern, this is one of the best cards as far as uplifting in the tarot. So with these two cards paired together, the Hermit is about taking time for yourself if you feel that that's what you need to do. Because you have the Ten of Cups, which is right around the corner, great times for yourself. Wish fulfillments coming your way. Happy family life. Great abundance is right around the corner or at your door. So with the Hermit card, you may feel like you need to take a break, but there's a quick turnaround in a great way, in a big way, with the Ten of Cups. And that's going to be your outcome. So Taurus, I hope this resonates. As you know, general readings, they don't always resonate with everyone. Then again, if you like this reading, please like, subscribe, leave a comment if that's what you like to do. I thank you so very much for watching, and have a great day.